Hello my dear students, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's class also we are continuing with the kinematics portion, and today is the last day of the revision exercise which we are doing about the kinematics. Okay, so next class onwards we'll be starting with projectile motion. And first question is, a ball is dropped vertically from a height d above the ground. It hits the ground and bounces up vertically to a height d by 2. Neglecting the subsequent motion and air resistance, its velocity v varies with height above the ground can be plotted as. So here a ball is dropped vertically from a height h above the ground. So ball is dropping from here. This is at a height h. So while we need to get the graph between velocity and the height, okay, we need to draw the velocity, how the velocity varies with the height above the ground, velocity and height. So both the cases we require the velocity. So here velocity, initial velocity will be equal to 0, and here height is h. And when it is coming here, what will happen? Velocity will become maximum velocity. It will reach to a maximum velocity when it covers height h. H will become equal to 0. And then in the second case, it is rebounding to a distance of d by 2. Okay, so this is rebounding to a distance of just half of the previous one. And in that case, initial velocity becomes v max, and final velocity will become equal to 0. This one, how can we represent it as a graph? So velocity is 0. In the first case, velocity is 0. It is increasing. So at a height h, this is h and this is velocity. At a height h, it is velocity is 0. So velocity is 0, or we can write it as h0. When it is coming to this position, 0 Vmax. So when height is decreasing, as time increases, height is decreasing and velocity becomes maximum value. So here, whether the velocity, it is under uniform acceleration. If it is under uniform acceleration, velocity and displacement, how the graph will be, it will be like this, right? It's a parabolic curve like this. Now the rest of the positions, in the second case, velocity is decreasing with respect to time. So velocity is maximum to 0, it is decreasing, that is, and height is increasing also. It is velocity is moving in the opposite direction, upward direction. It is moving in the upward direction means it's against gravity. So we will consider negative value, and distance is, it's just half of this. So here we will be getting the graph like this. Here the answer is yes, correct only. This is for d and this is d by 2 distance. This is d. Okay, so velocity distance graph like this. Each and every point find out and draw the graph. Clear? Here the correct option is A. Second question. Driver of a train moving at a speed V1 sights a freight train at a distance D ahead of him on the same track moving in the same direction with a slow speed V2. So first train is moving with the speed V1, and another train, he is seeing another train which is at a distance D ahead of him on the same track and moving with a slower velocity than V1. That velocity is V2. He puts on the brake and gives his train a constant deceleration alpha. So the deceleration is alpha, that means the train is coming to rest position. Then there will be no collision if D is. How much should be D? That's what the question is. So how can we find out what will be the value of D? So first train is moving with the velocity V1, and the second train is moving with the velocity V2. So here he is applying brake, and it is at a distance D away. Okay, this is the position of V1 and this is the position of V2. The distance is D. and at this position he is giving a deceleration of alpha, right? So how can we find out the value of d value at what distance, if it is not colliding, how much distance it can be, minimum how much distance it can be, that one we can find out. Okay, so here we know the we can find out the velocity. So which velocity we need to consider comparing to this, comparing to v2, what will be the velocity of v1, right? Both are moving, so the distance should be covered accordingly. Both are moving, therefore here we need to consider the relative velocity. Relative velocity of the train will be v1 minus v2. So it is coming to rest position, na? So it is final velocity will be equal to 0. Here we can write down initial velocity, we are taking the relative velocity. It is coming to rest position before collision, that is final velocity is equal to 0. Acceleration we know, which formula we can use, v square minus u square equals 2as. So here v square is 0 minus v1 minus v2 the whole square equals 2 into minus alpha into distance d. So how much will be d? D will be v1 minus v2 the whole square divided by 2 alpha. So here when we are considering d, we got it as v1 minus v2 the whole square by 2 alpha. So minimum it should have a distance of this much. Or if more than that, this distance if it is having, also it won't be colliding, or minimum this much it should be. So that is d should be greater than v1 minus v2 the whole square divided by 2 alpha. Or this much or greater than this much, then it can, it won't be colliding. Now it will be at a distance d, and if it is covering a distance v1 minus v2 the whole square divided by 2 alpha greater than that, it won't be colliding. Clear? So the condition is C, v1 minus v2 the whole square divided by 2 alpha. Clear? So next question is, a body is thrown vertically up with a velocity u. It passes three points A, B and C in its upward journey with velocities u by 2, u by 3, u by 4 respectively. The ratio of separations between the points A, B, A and B and between B and C. So distance AB by AC, BC, that one we need to find out. So an object is throwing upward and at three different positions we are considering. At A it is U by 2 and B it is U by 3 and C it is U by 4. We need to find out the ratio of AB and BC. So here I am considering the three points. So an object is, a ball is A is the first point, B here is the second point, C here is the third point. Here it is with velocity u by 2, here it is u by 3 and this is it, u by 4. We need to find out AB divided by BC. How can we find out? It is throwing upward with a velocity u. When, so initial velocity is u. When I am considering from O to A, O to A, when I am considering, distance covered will be, this is first distance I am taking it as S1 and this distance I am considering it as S2 and this distance I am considering it as S3. So we can find out S1, S2. S2 minus S1 will give you AB. The same way S2, S3 minus S2 will give you BC. For, so our aim is to find out thus AB and BC. First S1, S2, S3. So for finding out S1, we have the initial velocity u, final velocity is u by 2, v is final velocity, initial velocity is u only, final velocity is u by 2, acceleration equals minus g. Right? So here S v square minus u square equals 2as, u by 2 the whole square minus u square equals 2 into a into s as s1. Right? Therefore u square by 4 minus u square, that is u square by 4 minus u square, we can write it as minus 3 u square by 4 equals minus 2gs. Therefore, S1 equals 3 divided by 8 u square by g. Right? Now, next is S2. S2, when same way we can calculate S2 as initial velocity is u, final velocity is u by 3 and distance is a equals minus g. Therefore, v square minus u square equals 2as2. U square by 9 minus u square equals minus 2g into s2. Right? Therefore, it is, we will be getting it as 8 u square divided by 9 equals minus 2g s2. Negative negative will get cancelled. Therefore, s2 equals 8 divided by 18 u square by g. Next is same way we can find out for S3 also. S3 we can find, we will be getting it as v square is u by 4 the whole square minus u square equals minus 2g into S3. Therefore, here we will be getting it as 16. So, 15 by 4, 16 u square equals into 2 divided by g equals S3. Now we can find out S2 minus S1 and S3 minus S2. S2 minus S1 when we are finding out, u square by g is common. U square by g into 8 by 18 minus 3 by 8. Okay, this one you can find out. U square by g into 64 minus 54 divided by 8 into 18. Therefore, this one we will get it as u square by g into 10 divided by 8 into 18. Let it be like that only. Anyway, ratio only. Na? So, while we are calculating the ratio, it will get cancelled. Next is S3 minus S2. S3 we already got it as u square by g into 15 divided by 32 minus 8 divided by 18. Therefore, u square by g into 15 into 18 minus 256 divided by 32 into 18. So, u square by g into 270 minus 256 divided by 32 into 18. U square by g into 270 minus 256 14 divided by 32 into 18. So these two, when we are taking the ratios, that is 10 divided by S2 and AB by BC only. Na? Therefore, 10 divided by 8 into 18 into, take the reciprocal and multiply. Therefore, 32 into 18 divided by, what is that, 14. Divided by 14. It's a bit long calculation only, but you can find out. Otherwise, what you can do is here minus u square, everything is minus u square, and taking the ratio there itself, you can simplify. Okay, so when you are doing the more calculations, you will get it as 5, here it is 7, here 4, 8 4s are 32, 4, and here again it is 18, 20 divided by 7. Okay, so the here are the answer is 20 by 7. The option is option D, 20 by 7. So it's a bit a long calculation, but the answer actually it is easy to find out. While we are throwing, three different points are given. So each point we can find out the S1, total distance covered. And when we are getting the total distance, AB will be equal to ST minus S1 and BC will be equal to S3 minus S2. Find out and calculation, if it is correct, it is easy to get the answer. Next question is, a particle moving along x-axis has an acceleration f at time t, given f equals f0 into 1 minus t by t. So, f is given as f0 into 1 minus t by capital T, where f0 and capital T are constants. at the particle at t equals 0 has zero velocity. T equals 0, velocity will be equal to 0. When f equals 0, the particle's velocity will be, what is the velocity of the particle? This is what it is asked. So when acceleration equals 0, what will be the velocity? So here, f equals f0, this is the acceleration. Acceleration is given like that. That means acceleration, I can write it as dv by dt. That is equal to f0 into 1 minus t by t. Therefore, dv equals f0 into 1 minus t by t into dt. Here our aim is to find out the velocity, right? When f is equal to 0. Therefore, we can find out the velocity from this equation. So while integrating, v equals f0 multiplying this with dt. That is changing the bracket. F0 dt, dv equals f0 dt minus f0 t by capital T into dt. Therefore, integral dv is v f0 t minus f0 by t into t square by 2 plus a constant. Okay, so here it is given when t equals 0, v equals 0 it is given. Therefore, c will be equal to 0. No need to find out the when t equals 0, v will be equal to 0. Therefore, when we are substituting t as 0, we will get 0 equals c. Therefore, no need to consider the value c. So we got the value of v as v equals f0 t minus f0 by capital T into t square by 2. And here when f equals 0, what is the condition? 0 equals f0 into 1 minus t by t. That means 1 minus t by t equals 0. Therefore t by t equals 1, small t equals capital T. When I am substituting that value over here, v equals f0 into capital T minus f0 by capital T into capital T square divided by 2. Therefore, you will get it as f0 t is common 1 minus half. 1 minus half is half f0 capital T divided by 2. In this also not so much to think and all. It's only mathematical calculation. Acceleration is given. We need to find out the velocity. So what I did? First we found out the value by integrating, found the value of v. And we got it as, since this condition is given, t equals 0, v equals 0. Since that condition is given, we got the value as constant is equal to 0. So no need to consider the constant value. Now, we apply the condition given f equals 0. F equals 0, we got the value small t as equal to the constant capital T. Substituting that value of small t over here, we got the final answer as f0 capital T divided by 2. Clear? So here the option is f0 capital T by 2, A, option A. Next one, the position x of a particle with respect to time t along x-axis is given by x is equal to 9t square minus t cube, where x is in meters and t in seconds. What will be the position of the particle when it achieves maximum speed along the positive x direction? So here position is given 9t square minus t cube. When it achieves maximum speed, when it is achieving maximum speed, after that, that means after that it can't increase its speed. That means it is under constant, it is acceleration will be equal to 0 because velocity is not changing. So here what can we do? Here display position is given, differentiate once, you will get velocity. Again differentiate it, you will get the acceleration. Then you can find out the that acceleration we can equate to 0. From that we will be getting value for t. Substitute that value of t and you will get the position. We'll do now. Here x is given as 9t square minus t cube. Maximum speed. Maximum speed means acceleration will be equal to 0. Therefore, dx by dt velocity is 18t minus 3t square. That is velocity. Then acceleration will be equal to dv by dt. This is v. Again differentiating, we will get it as 18 minus 60. So at maximum speed acceleration will be equal to 0. Therefore, 18 minus 60 equals 0. T, we got it as 3 seconds. So, at 3 seconds, what will be the position? Position at T equals 3 seconds. Therefore, it as will be equal to 9. Here it is 27. 81 minus 27, that is equal to 54 meter. Okay, clear? So this is about the, these are some of the questions which is given in the DC Pandey Sir's book. All the questions I didn't do because it will take lot of time to complete one chapter. So next class onwards we will be starting the next portion, that is projectile motion. I think you would have got an idea about the kinematics. Around 35-36 videos we did based on the kinematics portion. Hope all of you are, all these videos are useful for you. And if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Thank you for watching. Bye.